From Loretto Abbey, home to the Sisters of Loretto since 1928, and the Loretto Abbey Secondary School, and with the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents Daily Mass.
The televising of this Mass is made possible by a contribution from the estate of José de Medeiros. This Mass is offered in memory of José, Maria, and Elizabeth de Medeiros. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who delight in innocence and restore it, direct the hearts of your servants to yourself, that caught up in the fire of your Spirit, we may be found steadfast in faith and effective in works. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed are those who trust in mere mortals and make mere flesh their strength, whose hearts turn away from the Lord. They shall be like a shrub in the desert and shall not see when relief comes. They shall live in the parched places of the wilderness, in an uninhabited salt land. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. They shall be like a tree planted by water, sending out its roots by the stream. It shall not fear when heat comes, and its leaves shall stay green. In the year of drought, it is not anxious, and it does not cease to bear fruit. The heart is devious above all else. It is perverse. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, test the mind and search the heart, to give to all according to their ways, according to the fruit of their doing. The word of the Lord.
Happy are they who hope in the Lord. Happy are they who hope in the Lord. Happy are those who do not follow the advice of the wicked, or take the path that sinners tread, or sit in the seat of scoffers. But their delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law they meditate day and night. Happy are they who like trees planted by streams of water, which yield their fruit in its season, and their leaves do not wither. In all that they do, they prosper. prosper. Happy are they who hope in the Lord. The wicked are not so, but are like chaff that the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. Happy are they who hope in the Lord. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. Blessed are they who have kept their word with a generous heart and yield a harvest through perseverance. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus told this parable to those among the Pharisees who loved money. There was a rich man who was dressed in purple and fine linen and who feasted sumptuously every day. And at his gate lay a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who longed to satisfy his hunger with what fell from the rich man's table. Even the dogs would come and lick his sores. The poor man died and was carried away by the angels to be with Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. In Hades, where he was being tormented, he looked up and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus by his side. He called out, "Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in agony in these flames." But Abraham said, "Child, remember that during your lifetime you received your good things, and Lazarus in like manner evil things. But now he is comforted here, and you are in agony. Besides all this, between you and us a great chasm has been fixed, so that those who might want to pass from here to you cannot do so, and no one can cross from there to us." The man who had been rich said, "Then, Father, I beg you to send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, that he may warn them so that they will not also come into this place of torment." Abraham replied, "They have Moses and the prophets. They should listen to them." He said, "No, Father Abraham, but if someone goes to them from the dead, they will repent." Abraham said to him, "If they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be convinced, even if someone rises from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord. Very often, I think, when we hear Jesus speaking to the Pharisees, we imagine the Pharisees as malicious or evil people, as people who are sinners in some way. And in this particular case especially, this would be very misleading. The Pharisees, we need to remember, were people who were trying very hard to live a life of holiness. And in fact, many of the concerns that they had were concerns that Jesus shared with them. So it's important for us to remember that Jesus is speaking not just to Pharisees, but to a very specific group of Pharisees. Pharisees who loved money. The gospel is very, very clear on that. And so we need to imagine not a group of malicious or evil or sinful men, but a group of good men who are trying to live a good life, but who have this one obstacle, their love of money. Once we hear the parable in that light, we realize, first of all, that the rich man, again, is not a bad person. The point of the parable is not somehow to point a finger at him and say, well, you're rich, therefore you're bad. Rather, his love of money, his wealth, has blinded him in his goodness to the plight of Lazarus. And what Abraham points out to him at the end of the parable is that that blindness has serious consequences, that in some sense, in spite of his desire to be good, in spite of his desire to serve God, the rich man has been misled by his love of wealth and has ended up in this place. So in some sense, the parable is not about converting from sin, but recognizing that I am blind, recognizing that there is this obstacle, even in my very goodness, to following the will of God without reserve, without limit. At the end of the parable, then, Abraham's statement to the rich man, if they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be convinced if someone rises from the dead, is as much a warning to the Pharisees as it is to us. In this season of Lent, can I become attentive to the ways in which I am misled in my very desire to be good, in my very desire to do God's will? Where am I blind? Where am I held back? Where do I need conversion, not from sin, but from blindness? And then the question becomes, in this season of Lent, how do I ask for God's grace to be freed from those obstacles, to find the courage and the wisdom to collaborate with that grace that I might be free to give my heart and my mind and my will over to God unreservedly? And here the first reading and the psalm are very helpful to us. If we try to fight obstacles head on, we give them a power that they needn't have. But if we hear the words of the first reading and the psalm, and in this season of Lent, take the time to go deeper in our love for God, to plant the roots by the stream more deeply, to allow them to reach living water, then we will have the resources to respond with God's grace to these obstacles, to invite God to free us from these blindnesses and these obstacles. So as we celebrate this Eucharist, as we continue our celebration of this season of Lent, let us ask that our roots would go deeper, that we would allow God's grace to take us more deeply into the love of God, that we might discover the gifts we need to overcome and be freed from those obstacles that prevent us from giving ourselves over to God with Christ. With this in mind, let us ask God for what we need. Let us ask for that Lenten grace of a deeper conversion to God's love at work in our lives, that we might give ourselves over to Christ more and more fully, we pray to the Lord. And let us pray for the church. Let us pray in particular for the church's ministers, priests, deacons, and bishops who are tasked with helping us to follow Christ, that they too would discover the resources they need in this time to minister to us from God's grace. More and more, we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for those who are in need, who, like Lazarus, are invisible to the powerful, invisible to the rich, that they would be helped from our resources, from the treasures of God's grace, we pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, we place before you these, our prayers. We place before you the needs of our world. Grant us what we truly need, that your glory may shine forth in our lives and your gospel may be preached to the ends of the earth. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. By this present sacrifice, we pray, O Lord, sanctify our observances, that what Lenten discipline outwardly declares, it may inwardly bring about through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us to imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the
indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's
offer one another a sign of that peace.
Love. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Will those of you at home join with me now in this prayer for courage? Grant me, O Lord, the strength to be who I must be, to do what I must do. Give me the courage to stand strong against my fears and have the will to express my feelings and needs. Help me realize that I have the power to change, no matter what anyone tells me, because of you. Give me the faith I need to believe in you always, even when it seems you're not there. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us pray. May this sacrifice, O God, remain active in its effects and work ever more strongly within us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
bow your heads for a blessing. Abide with your servants, O Lord, who implore the help of your grace, that they may receive from you the support and guidance of your protection through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to proclaim the gospel by your living.
Our thanks to our donor for the gift of this Mass. If you're interested in making monthly donations using the pre-authorized checking method, please call our office at 1-888-383-6277 for details.
Accept the contrite prayer. Our hearts are